I'm a boss bitch, like I'm a this, I'm a that. No, baby, like, but you can't cook.
Okay.
You don't know when to be quiet. You don't know how to allow a man to lead.
The last part that he said, you don't know how to shut up and things like that. I think that comes from just a lack of respect, ultimately. You know how to shut up at your job. You know how to shut up when things are important. You know how to shut up when things that you respect. So I don't want to make it seem like this is just this. You got to be submissive or you just got to be a subordinate to the man. No, you just have to respect him. You just have, like, women, oh, I need my respect. I need the respect. A woman constantly talking out her mouth inside her neck or trying to be right is disrespectful. That's the same for a man. If I'm talking to a woman just trying to be right, just being argumentative, just cutting them off, just being shameful, that's disrespectful. If there's a dude or a person that has more intelligence than me than the conversation, and I keep trying to overtalk them and act like I know more than them, that is disrespectful. Well, to imagine that. I'm trying to get tutored by this great salesman or great football coach or some shit like this, but I think I know how to do it better than him. You think that nigga gonna want to keep coaching me? You think that nigga, like, he's going to feel disrespected. What's good? It's your boy BNLK, okay, Emerald Thoughts. We back in the building. What's the reaction for y'all, man? We're going to be reacting to some Cam Newton conversation and some of the things that he said the past few days or that happened a few days ago. And get right into it. Obviously, this was a little controversial. It was a little debatable. But the thing I wanted to kind of point out before we get into this, I don't think Cam Newton's red pill. I don't think Cam Newton's a part of the manosphere. He might have watched the Kevin Samuels video too, but I think this is more than a rich man. I think this is more than a red pill or more than a misogynist man speaking. I think this is the average thought of a regular man. And we're going to kind of break down some of his thoughts. We're going to watch the full video, then we're going to kind of go back and dissect some of the things he talked about. Then maybe we're going to get into this Undisputed and First Take a conversation about it too.
A person who's just, you know, girl, I'm a bad bitch. You know, I'm doing this, I'm doing that. I look the part, but I don't act the part.
Okay.
You know, and it's a lot of women who are bad bitches, and I say bitches in a way not to degrade a woman, but just to go off the aesthetic of what they deem is a boss chick.
Mm-hmm.
Now, a woman for me is handling your own, but knowing how to cater to a man's needs, mm-hmm. right? And I think a lot of times when you get that aesthetic of like, I'm a boss bitch, like I'm a this, I'm a that. No, baby, like, but you can't cook.
Okay.
You don't know when to be quiet. You don't know how to allow a man to lead. You know, girl, I'm a bad bitch. You know, I'm doing this, I'm doing that. I look the part, but I don't act the part.
Okay.
You know, and it's a lot of women who are bad bitches. And I say bitches in a way not to degrade a woman.
And when I think he said they are a lot of bad bitches, like when you talk about women that got their shit together, salute to them. There's a lot of women that are self-made to a certain degree. I think when you talk about self-made women or women that got degrees or women that worked their way up in the society or their job field or whatever, that's what he means by bad bitches. They're basically a bachelor or a bachelorette, and they got this money they can spend on themselves so they can go on vacations, they can live up the lifestyle, they can be materialistic, they can show all the glamour and stuff like that. So they're, by all means, they're bad bitches. They can get all the new weaves because they got a good paying job for an individual that you can't really be mad at. So when he say that they're bad bitches, that's what I would refer to when we talk about that. Of course, when we look into women in these societies, like, obviously y'all doing y'all thing. I think, when the Brittany Renner conversation come up, when we'd be like, well, when Red Pill or Fresh was like, you're not different, we're not talking about you're no different in the totality of what you've done in society, but we're talking about in relationships. And this would be an example of, like, with Cam Newton saying, yeah, Josh should tone it down. We're talking about in the aspects of relationships. So it's not necessarily what you've done in outside and in the world that's, you know, for your own selfish gains or your own individual gains. I should say not selfish, but let's move on.
But just to go off the aesthetic of what they deem is a boss chick.
Mm-hmm.
Now, a woman for me is handling your own, but knowing how to cater to a man's needs.
And with a man's needs and a man that I think like Cam Newton or any man that wants to be his best version, he wants to be able to have a life where his woman can tend to him and she don't have to worry about going to work. She don't have to worry about stressing outside of anything that's dealing with households. He don't want to stress with household stuff if it's a man really doing his thing. Of course, it's going to happen. But a man does his best, or a leader does his best to mitigate the stress, I would say. So when Cam Newton talks about, like, you can do your own thing, you can have a life. A lot of women say, oh, I need to work and stuff like that. You can have hobbies. You can have things where you're just not underneath me. You can have a personality. Like, that's what he mean. Like, you can do you, but you can still cater to me. But I think when you talk about these independent women or these boss women, I even seen Malia Peterson or whatever her name is. She was like, how you can have a career and tend to your child. Like, when it talks about tending to a child, when it talks about tending to a man, when it talks about tending to a household, that is a full-time job. So if you're trying to work a real job and career that's going to stress you out, you're going to start to slack on whatever one you deem less important. And for women, of course, they're going to take their kids to a certain extent, but your kids is even going to – that's why I brought up the Malia Peterson. Your kids are going to miss out on you. You can have this illusion of why you can be successful in both, but something's going to slack. And honestly, I can make up this facade like, oh, you're going to have an amazing work life and your child life is going – or your house life is going to suffer a little bit. But you're going to suffer in both. Let's be real. It's not going to be one or the other. You're trying to do both eggs. Those are two eggs that just you got to keep them in the same basket. Like, they're just taking too much energy away from yourself. You're literally trying to take care of two different households, whether it's your business or whether it's your family household, because your family household is a business, if we're being real. And not in it, let's just talk about financial gains, but we just talking about generational wealth, different benefits that you can get out of it. If you take it seriously, you can reap just as much benefits in that family dynamic as you can in a side of a corporate dynamic that calls each other family, friends, partners, or whatever the fuck they like to call each other to make the team chemistry sound great. So that's when I think when Cam Newton talks about our needs, it's like, no, you don't have to fuck us 24/7, but we would like the house clean. We would like at least two or three meals a day. Yeah, like, we're going to need to eat two or three times a day. We don't want to go out all the damn time. We want your cooking. So you need to be creative. You need to be on your toes with different things that I like. You need to know how to make things exactly the way I like it. Nigga, let me just be funny real quick. How I eat my ramen noodles, that nigga got to be flipped. It got to be cooked for 2 minutes, one side. Cause I eat two packs. 2 minutes, flip them hoes, another 2 minutes. If it ain't al dente, 30 seconds. Don't cook it no more longer than that because the water going to cook it. If it's more than that, I do not want them hoes. Obviously, I ain't trying to put nobody through that much stress, but on other simple things or other meals and stuff like that, a way that I like it. You know, I kind of like spicy food, so you tend to make more spicy food. You know what I mean? So I think that's what it, when he means tend to your man and know what he wants, because a man that you want, how a woman describes, he got to be the shit. He got to be able to maintain a certain lifestyle. So if you're going to have a lifestyle that you want, you better be able to facilitate and meet the needs that he want. And I would say most of them are going to be household-oriented or family-based or oriented in a sense.
Mm-hmm. Right. And I think a lot of times when you get that aesthetic of, like, I'm a boss bitch, like, I'm a this, I'm a that. No, baby. Like, but you can't cook.
Okay.
You don't know when to be quiet. You don't know how to.
And let's be real, can't cook go hard, bro. Because if you really can cook, that means you can cook different. You can cook different cultures. Most women only can cook soul food, so we gonna eat chicken, fried chicken, and spaghetti or some shit, some weak ass Italian food, and then the rest is fast food, but or whatever. But a creative woman that really got different cultures and recipes in her, bro, it's all day long. The it's fun cooking. It'll be fun cooking because you just get to do shit. The man just get happy because it's a new surprise. Like, It goes so far, bro. And instead of him having to actually travel to these places or him actually having to go out to a restaurant, sometimes he just want that at home. And it's not like he won't go to those places, but do I want to do that shit all the time? No, I'm not fucking Superman. I'm not trying to fly to fucking London just for a bagel, my nigga.
Allow a man to lead. Bad bitches.
So the last part that he said, you don't know how to shut up and things like that. I think that comes from just a lack of respect, ultimately. You know how to shut up at your job. You know how to shut up when things are important. You know how to shut up when things that you respect. So I don't want to make it seem like this is just this. You got to be submissive or you just got to be a subordinate to the man. No, you just have to respect him. You just have, like, women, oh, I need my respect. I need the respect. A woman constantly talking out her mouth inside her neck or trying to be right is disrespectful. That's the same for a man. If I'm talking to a woman just trying to be right, just being argumentative, just cutting them off, just being shameful, that's disrespectful. If there's a dude or a person that has more intelligence than me than the conversation, and I keep trying to overtalk them and act like I know more than them, that is disrespectful. Well, to imagine that. I'm trying to get tutored by this great salesman or great football coach or some shit like this, but I think I know how to do it better than him. You think that nigga gonna want to keep coaching me? You think that nigga gonna, like, he's gonna feel disrespected. So that's the, when women don't know how to shut up, it's not that we just need you to be a puppet, but we do need some respect. We do need you, let you know, like, when we're having a serious conversation, we really need to get something off our chest, don't cut us off. Don't just be quick to respond. Actually listen to us. Actually know that we doing a lot, wearing our heart on our sleeve and even trying to have this conversation with you because we know how you can take it. But, like, all that goes out the window when you get emotional. But I think it's a lack of respect because there's many times in your life where you've been emotional, you had to check that shit. Whether it's with your parents, whether it's with your job, whether it's with some police officer, whether... I know I like to, like, give this, I'm giving all these power dynamics, but it's not about the power. It just so happened that you respect power, so I have to go to those sources. But it should be that way with your child. You shouldn't just say anything to your child. You shouldn't just have any type of conversation with your child. It's a respect thing. So I shouldn't have to necessarily say powerful, even though your child is a powerful thing as well. But it's just a respect thing. You shouldn't talk like that to people that you don't deem that has power. This is a respect thing. So that's the main conversation that I want people to understand. When men talk about we need women to be quiet, it's about respecting our time. It's about respecting our energy and understanding that we got a battle of the world. And you're hearing your little problems. And when I say little, the little gossip shit. If it's a family situation, emergency, you know the nigga gonna drop everything on his plate and take care of you. That's 9 times out of 10, unless he really has some emergency shit going on in his life, your shit's going to come up. And he's going to put that shit to the side. So a lot of times, women that come and nag us about some or talk about some shit, it's nagging or talking about shit that we don't care about where they could have shared that with their friends or just held that shit in and had a more constructive way to approach the topic instead of just nagging. And... like I said, that's with respect to the man's energy, time, and things that he has to, like he has to go battle the world. And then he got to worry about, like, being confrontational or argumentative or, like, thinking about a woman, like when you talk about these boss women or these independent women, when they get into these relationships, they want the power, they want the respect, but they don't want to necessarily give it. So it's like a wild horse, bro. You'll never really be able to buck this horse. And I talked to my homeboy, and he was like, you don't think so? If she really just got this most power, like if she got a dude that was way more alpha than her? I said, I agree. That's what she needs. She needs to be checked. She needs to do that because she said she needed a beta male. This woman said it out her mouth. She needed a beta male. And... because she liked to run over him all that. But in reality, she needs somebody to check her. But this is what I said. I think it'll work until she gets a baby or get married. Then she starts to gain leverage. And then once she starts to get leverage, she starts to lose respect for what that man has, the initial power or alpha that nigga may have because of the leverage that she gained. Now she deems that as power, which she don't have to necessarily respect anymore. That's how I kind of see it. And we see that women will play these games or they'll be so submissive until they get that leverage. And I don't know if it's intentional or unintentional, But that's what happens. Like, they seem like they're a tame horse, or I just to use this analogy, and once they get that like I said, that those examples, they start bucking just as hard as when in the beginning, when they were dating beta dudes and running over dudes and was a player and pimping. So I'll leave that there. I'm pretty sure we're gonna come back to this conversation because we about to watch these. So I don't want to stay on that too long, but let's get into some. What's this first take?
Under fire on social media after making
surprisingly, I think Stephen A. agreed with him, but let's see.
Comments about how he believes women should act while appearing on the $1 Million Worth of Game podcast on Sunday, saying, quote, "Now, a woman for me is handling your own, but knowing how to cater to a man's needs, right? And I think a lot of times when you get that aesthetic of I'm a boss bee, I'm a this, I'm a that, no baby, but you can't cook, you don't know when to be quiet, you don't know how to lead, how to allow a man to lead." Okay, let's take a moment and unpack this.
I wish Molly would be careful with this conversation because she's married. I wish Molly would be careful with this conversation because she's not black. She's gonna take it as a woman thing, but not as the statistics of how fucked our community is. And that's the disrespect that I just hate with liberal people. They're so liberal, they start to miss some of the issues that need to be addressed to actually be productive.
Reaction. I want you to go ahead.
You notice I'm the only man here, right?
Yeah.
All of them ran.
Because I want everyone to know, everyone else was scared to touch this subject. No, in all seriousness, that's why I respect you, because you don't shy away from anything. And you'll take the heat when it comes.
Let me say this. It's a couple of things. The first order of business, I want to tell a little fun story.
Okay.
I got a brother, we call him Money Mark. Mm-hmm. He knows who he is. It's my brother. You know, I love you, bro. And here's the deal. One of my childhood buddies had gotten into an argument with his wife, and it was all of us around. This happened like 3 years ago or so.
Yep.
And we were all hanging out at a spot in Atlanta.
Yep.
And one of my childhood buddies had gotten into an argument with his wife, and F that, I ain't taking this, blah, 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 you know, sticking out his chest, you know, just going off, right?
Yeah.
And he was telling us some of the things that he was saying while he was going off to her. And my boy Money Mark said, "Can't talk to a woman like that. You can't sit up there and talk out of your mouth and have that."
Why not? I thought we were equal.
And be all disrespectful and then have your hand out for the electric bill. You can't do that. And all of us just rolled laughing.
Hello.
Because in a bigger way, it's a bigger point.
Yeah.
And it's something that Cam Newton missed along the way.
I'm missing it too at this point.
You can talk about the role that you want to play. You want a woman to play in your life. But guess what? What about the role you play?
All right, I thought he'd agreed, but nigga, we know what role they want us to play. We don't. That's what's crazy. A woman can say 24/7 what they want. A man brings up an inkling. He didn't even go in really description. He didn't really get descriptive. And let's just. Let's rewind it. We're talking about Cam fucking Newton. He can offer the world to a woman. Irrelevant point. And the most women that men want can offer the world to them. So, yeah, bitch, you better be able to give something.
Mm-hmm. What about the level of inspiration and motivation that you give her to be all you want her to be?
I guess we got dissected bit by bit. This goes into the conversation that I was having with my homeboy with the girl that said she liked to date beta dudes. He said, if you're a super alpha, whatever, you just know the game, you know how to play with her, you can handle that. My thing is, first of all, it's going to be tiring and draining because she's going to keep bucking. And second, it's like, is she really going to change? When we talk about these boss women, when we talk about these independent women. Now, a regular woman, every woman has, every person in general has to kind of be molded to fit their spouse. And the longer they know them, they kind of fit them almost like a glove. So that naturally happens. But I think these independent women fight that natural process along with any coaching. So that's why I think Stephen A is missing a point here.
What about the fact that she has the choice to be what she wants to be? And the choices that she made was why you wanted her to begin with.
That's not true. He just said they're unattractive. That rah-rah, don't know how to cook. Nothing attractive about him. So I don't know what he's saying right here. He literally said they're not attractive. And I think the average man says they're not attractive. I don't think Stephen A is married to a woman that can't cook, that thinks she's an alpha woman that don't need him. If he is, he's a simp.
That's what he's missing in all of this.
I don't even think Molly's following this nigga at this point.
About a woman in the fashion that he just articulated. There's nothing wrong if you are a man. I want to play this role. I want my woman to play this role. But it's co-signing. It's a partnership. Everybody, whatever role, but you got some women, okay, you might know how to.
I was not going to try to make this a long video. Man, it is not a partnership. She put on your last name. Nigga, that's your team. Nigga, you buy the jerseys. you pay the coaching. Nigga, you pay the fees. Like, nigga, this is your team. if it wasn't, she wouldn't be taking your name. like a woman should want to have your last name, first of all. Shouldn't be a negotiation. A woman should be, I am Cam Newton's wife. I am Mrs. Newton. That, like, she should be proud of that, because that's how accomplished her man is. Even in his own right. My man is this. He got this. He do this. He do that. I am proud to be with him. He's an amazing father. All this other shit. I am proud to be. I'm a proud to have that last name. It's not a partnership.
Some women don't want to cook. She wants you to cook. And you the better cook than her. Brings this other things to the table.
It's crazy conversation.
You make sure you make these kind of discussions and you make these kind of judgment calls. That's how you. Isn't necessarily applicable to every man. And when you.
He said, for me, dumbass. And even then, the majority, not even the average, the majority of men would speak the same way that Cam Newton spoke. I don't give a fuck how politically correct this nigga Stephen A. trying to be.
Hear somebody like Cam Newton say the things that he said, here's what I think he missed. Mm-hmm. Everyone knows that Cecil Newton, Cam Newton's father, has a profound impact on his life. He is a good man by all accounts from people who meet him, talk about him, et cetera, right? When Cam Newton makes a statement like this, he has a mother who's been married to his father for many, many years, and one would deduce you must have saw your mother play a role. Well, guess what? The role that she's played in his life is because of the role he's played in hers. Mm-hmm. The same man that you admire, that woman has been his rock, his iron. She's been by his side.
But he could have said those qualities. He could have said loyalty, loving, exactly. Rock by his side.
He didn't, though. So what's the problem? He want a woman to be quiet? Maybe he's seen his mom knew how to shut up. Maybe he's seen his mom know how to hold her tongue and be ladylike and not come and try to compete with her own husband. When she seen things are unproductive, she got out of it and waited till he cooled down, because she know how a man typically, like, you want to know what? I will give y'all a perfect example. So I had a perfect analogy. Like I said, we're talking about these women when a man get upset, or a man trying to speak his voice or whatever in a relationship, it starts to get competitive, it starts to get argumentative. This is what a feminine woman would do versus, I'm going to show y'all what a, we'll get into it after, what the other, the boss woman would get, or do, excuse me.
Sun's getting real low.
Look, if it's more of body language here. This is the communication you're going to get out of this one. It's not aggressive. She knows he's a fucking beast. She respects his aggression. And look what she's able to get from him. Any other approach would have been miserable, would have been horrible, unproductive, right? Probably got ass slung across the motherfucking map. Think of the analogy here. If any woman wants to know how to get to a man, be submissive. That is power in itself. Because you trying to do what a boss woman does, argue, confront, combat. Imagine doing that to the Hulk. What the results of that would be. You arguing with the motherfucking Hulk. You wouldn't do it, right? It's not a smart approach. But like I said, the power, he got so much power, you got to respect him. But like I said, you can clearly see the respect level for the man is not there. It's just not. It's just not. Even if he had power or not, it's just not there. But a submissive woman, she'll cuddle her way to sleep or cuddle that person down until they can have a productive conversation. Or just wait till the temperatures have settled down until she has the conversation. But most women antagonize, make it worse. Pick the bear, poke the bear. Well, when you're poking the Hulk, a lot of times that's when these women end up in a lot of violent and domestic situations because they don't know how to be quiet. And I am sorry. I am sorry I have to say that because a lot of people won't understand it. But not all of them, of course. But a lot of times, the dynamic between men and women aren't being respected, and women are using their version of violence and mental abuse towards the man, and the man uses his version of violence back, which is physical. Unfortunately, there's domestic abuse on both sides, but what we judge more harshly is the physical abuse, which is usually a reaction to the mental abuse that's been going on. Whether it's by that woman or some shit that's traumatizing that's happened in the past, regardless. It happens. So, let's move on.
Exactly. Through the thick and the thin, but he went straight to the antiquated stereotype.
Antiquated stereotype, which a lot of...
It's not antiquated because men still want that. How is that antiquated? Men don't want women to shut up. Men don't want women that respects them. That knows when to talk and not to? That's crazy. You don't think I want a woman that know how to cook for my children? I'm so confused. How is that antiquated? Being loyal and all that shit is like it's like fantasy shit. Let's talk about some actual like shit that really bothers a man or what really wants a man. A man is always hungry. That's just our digestive system. Can you keep that full? A man is always horny to a certain degree. I'm being like a little hyperbolic when I say these things. Can you keep him not horny? A man always wants peace. Can you mind that peace? These are not antiquated thoughts. They're rudimentary and fundamental. So if someone 1900 years ago was saying that, and somebody was in 2022 saying it, because it has some fucking credence, not because it's antiquated. You wouldn't keep hearing this shit. You know how many words and sayings and ideas has fallen to the wayside? If this shit is still prevalent for decades and millenniums, nigga gotta eat, nigga gotta fuck. Crazy to me.
Of men have. And the real problem that a lot of women, the point that you're talking about, a dude, I've never been married. I didn't want to be married. Mm-hmm. That might change later. But
hey, now.
You know, the point that I'm making is that it's by choice. Because obviously I could have a wife if I wanted to. I've just been blessed in that regard. But here's the point. In the end, what it comes down to.
How are you allowed to say that, Stephen A? How do you know you're going to inspire a woman? Because you know the lifestyle you're going to give her better be fucking inspirational enough. My last name on your back better be inspirational enough. Like, if I want to take you out, if I want to wear a shiny jacket, bitch, that's cherry on top. But everything else, You getting a full fridge? Bitch, you could be back in your Section 8 apartment. I'm being funny. It might not be Section 8. You could be back in your little condo apartment with a motherfucking yogurt cup and some nuggets in the freezer. And that's about it. Or you could be in my motherfucking place in this cool ass L and these nice ass cars with the pool outside. With all exclusive passes where you can go anywhere you want, because just because you Cam Newton's wife and Cam Newton got all access to it, you got access to it. And that happens. That definitely happens. So, the inspiration conversation that he brought up, my life should be inspiring enough. And if it's not, maybe I need to work on myself as a man, or maybe you need to reevaluate your life because you ain't had that much anyways.
Was this.
Maybe.
You don't disrespect the woman by sitting there and talking about them like that.
Yeah.
And then.
What do you mean talking about them like that? He didn't even talk about no one. He didn't. Oh, I guess he did talk about boss women. But he said prototypical. And I mean, are we lying? They don't know how to cook. They would admit that. These are. We just can't call a spade, bro.
And generalizing that way. Now, some people look and they'll say, Stephen A., you've had your issues in the past where you said this. Well, you know, Steph Curry, Aisha Curry from years ago. I will remind people, I wasn't talking about gender. I'm talking about the role somebody plays. If somebody's in the public eye and you're not in the public eye, be careful about what you say because it could be a reflection on them. Mm-hmm. Same with Hillary Clinton and Bill Clinton. Mm-hmm. You know, that's all. But I misspoke.
Yeah, and you learn from it.
And you learn from it and you go forward.
Exactly.
The point that I'm making is that in the end, if you're Cam Newton, just in 2017, you said it was funny when a female reporter asked you about running routes and literally said, it's funny that a female is asking about running routes. Is this
it's not. I seen a girl throw the ball like 30, 40 yards and it was a tight spiral. Nigga, I was amazed. What are you talking about? A woman knowing the intricacies of basketball or football, she should be complimented or acknowledged that she's like rare because most women don't. Not to the extent that she may know it. So you can't even give a woman a compliment without niggas looking at it like, oh, it's misogynistic. Like, no, nigga, based off statistics alone, she's rare, nigga. What are you talking about? Oh, Molly can't tell you about route combinations and route trees, and she's on a sports show. So a woman that actually is the analytical, like, and not just a mediator or a co-host that looks good. Come on now. Or know how to talk about the politics inside of sports, because that's what a lot of women and these men know how to do. They don't really be knowing the intricacies of sports and the dynamics and the system that go around them. They know the politics around sports. That's why they're able to get on these shows. So, like I said, when a woman's able to break down some technical shit, you should be able to compliment her, especially if you don't see that often. That's weird, bro. That's like me, like a white dude complimenting a black millionaire or billionaire or some shit like that, or being a dude, seeing him in a place that he never been. It's like, oh, you made billions? Like, oh, that's what's up, man. I never really see black billionaires. Well, nigga, he's probably right. Like, he's not. It's not like some statements are just reality. It's nothing crazy about them, but it's nothing more to say to this nigga or listen to anything he has to say. So I'm just gonna kill it here and leave it there. But hey, man, y'all been going crazy. My subs went up. The views been going up off of that Will Smith. It's complicated. I'm going to drop some more. I don't know if it was the Will Smith or I don't know if it was It's Complicated or both, because I know It's Complicated is popular, but I'm going to do a little bit of the It's Complicated some more. But I really appreciate it, man. 30, 40 new subscribers. Hey, shout out to y'all, man. I hope y'all enjoy the channel, bro. It's going to be nothing but thoughtful and thought-provoking conversations. So, man, I appreciate it. Y'all keep going crazy. Y'all keep liking this shit up, man. And, hey, man, I can't see. I just want to see how big we can get, man. I want to be to a point where I'm like, man, I can never believe this shit. And I think I know y'all. As a matter of fact, I know y'all can get me there. So we're going to speak it into existence, man. Peace. Oh, nigga, Philip. Stop listening.